Simply Done, the podcast network.
How many of these movies you think you've seen?
I don't know. I've seen Citizen Kane.
Citizen Kane?
Yeah, you seen that, Scaremaster?
Who was in that movie? Don?
Citizen Kane?
Yeah.
John Cusack.
John Cusack was the star, and it had...
Lady Antebellum?
And a very young Paul Rubens was in there.
Yeah, I don't believe I saw that movie.
Okay, here, I'm going to read off number 318, Rebecca.
Who's that?
That's Alfred Hitchcock. It's great. Mary Jane, did you ever see Rebecca? You would love it.
Yeah, you would. I tried to show it to her once.
It's great. Last night I dreamt of Mandalay.
The best of the Big Three podcast.
This is where we do the song at the beginning of the best of podcasts.
Here it goes.
Yeah, well, nice ad there. Coming to you pre-recorded from Simply Down the Podcast Network Studios at a secret location in West Hollywood, California. It's the best of the Big Three podcast. Hi, I'm your pal, Don Barris.
I'm your pal, Ball.
And I'm, of course, the best of Scary Perry Caravello.
Yeah.
What the fuck does that mean?
Well, first off, I let you guys use my band, Retribution.
No, I asked them.
You asked me to ask them.
No, and then I asked them, and they said it was fine.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so a band that has been broken up.
3 years.
And we actually put them on a podcast, and they got some people. It was a very nice thing for them.
They were on my podcast, too.
So why do you, but your podcast goes nowhere.
Your public access show, excuse me.
And your public access show went nowhere.
Well, because I didn't work for a guy named Jimmy Kimmel at the time, like you do.
Well, what does that mean?
Because if you didn't work for a guy named Jimmy Kimmel like you do, you'd be in the same shoes as I am.
No, I would get another job.
Maybe working somewhere else. He closes every night at the Comedy Store.
Yeah, I got plenty of audience warm-up before that, and I've had plenty of shows that I worked on before. So, Perry, you're absolutely wrong. Now, the reason we're doing these best of shows is because, Perry, you are in the hospital right now.
Okay.
How many people do you think will visit you this time?
Let's see. You, Mole, Mary Jane.
That's the people that visited you last time.
Heather, Carol.
I bet you need... You know what? I'll tell you this. Just as a side note, I know we're in the middle of a best of, but it doesn't seem like they like you very much.
Well, can I tell you something, you guys?
What's that?
We're going to be having a candlelight vigil out in front of Scaremaster's... hospital.
Why?
to have fun.
Who's going to show up?
A lot of people.
Name three.
You, me, Mary Jane.
All right. Well, you got me there, I guess.
Neil
Leeds. Four. He doesn't want anything to do with this.
Yeah, he's a man of prayer, though. He may.
Neil Leeds is a cool cat.
Why is he a cool cat?
He's a nice guy. He's a nice guy.
Leave your fucking hat alone and talk into the mic. Let me hold
it. No, you're not going to hold it. No.
Okay, what are we going to do, Mole? What?
I don't know. We got to do a best of show.
Yeah, what do you want to do on this best of show?
What does Scaremaster want to do?
You guys tell me what you want
to
do.
Well,
you
think
come
about
up with
it.
An idea.
Think of something that we've done before, and think of what you'd like to hear again, and we can talk about it. Is there anything that we've done on the show
you
liked?
I don't like anything that you've done on the show, because it's always against me. There's nothing nice said about me, nothing nice done for me or to me on the show, other than the times that you guys give me some shout-out money. But lately, I've been punished, so I don't get any shout-out money. And I don't know why I'm being punished, but because I didn't do anything wrong.
Do you remember what happened? They said, Dan said that you're on probation because of what you did, so that you learned from your mistakes, but you just said you didn't learn. You don't know what you did that he's getting punished. Now you got to go back another 2 weeks because you didn't learn. You don't remember what you did?
You don't remember, Perry?
Think, dude. You can remember. Think.
What did I do?
Come on, think.
I'm too sick. I'm too sick and too
fucked up. You raped those kids.
What?
I don't know if that's the reason that we took away things from him. I think it was because when he was supposed to be here at a show, he just didn't show up.
I raped
that
kids?
No, it wasn't rape kids.
I don't rape kids. I don't rape anybody.
You missed the show. That's what I meant. You meant the show. You missed the show.
Foot rape Heather.
Oh, God.
Did you not just
touch? That's not fucking rape.
I don't know.
That's not fucking rape.
No, I know. That's what I said. I was mistaken.
I want to get out of here is what I want to do.
Oh, well, you can't get out of here. We have a damn show to do, Perry. All right. I've asked some people that are real close to the show to tell us what their favorite clips from the podcast were. So they all called me. They left a message telling me what they'd like to hear on today's Best of podcast. And today we'll start out with the producer that saved Windy City Heat. This Romanian businessman put the money needed when the Japanese investor backed out. And to make sure that he's not mad at me, I'm going to play his clip first. So leading off today's Best of podcast, here's Romanian businessman, producer of Windy City Heat, Yurgi.
Don Beres is Yurgi businessman. Listen, Don, two things, okay? One, I'm very pissed and angry because my Natasha, who I brought by your podcast out of goodness of my heart, now she has genital chlamydia. And I'm absolutely sure that she gets it from Perry, which is disgusting looking at her. He has infected her pussy with chlamydia crabs. Two, other point, I want that episode where I was on podcast for the first time. I want that in your Best of show, and that is non-negotiable. Put it in. I give you money for your fucking movie. You put me in the fucking radio show. It's the Best of. Do it. Get it done.
We've had a guy that's tried to get in touch with you for quite some time who's a little mad, who said he'd like to talk to you today. So may I bring in to the studio a former businessman, he probably still is, but the one of the producers of the movie Windy City Heat. Say hello to Yurgi and Natasha.
Oh,
they're here.
Where is he? There he is. I see him.
Hey.
Okay, grab a seat. Put on your cans. Hello, Natasha. Hello, Yurgi. How are you?
Hi, Yurgi.
No. Okay. I tell you what to fuck. Okay.
Hey, you guys.
Hello, Yurgi. Put on your headphones. Put your headphones. There's a headphone right there. Well, welcome, Yurgi. You were the former producer of the movie Windy City Heat.
That's right.
You're Romanian.
It's nice to see the Yurgi.
Businessman.
Oh, now Yurgi is a former producer of the movie?
He wasn't?
He was.
I don't know.
Of course I was. Don't you know who butters your bread, for Christ's sake?
Remember we lost the funding and who he stepped in
that's
to fund
right.
the movie?
If not for
Yurgi,
that's right.
Windy City Heat would still be just a dream in your head, Scaremaster.
You came here today because you wanted to say something to Perry. You came the same day that Perry decided to skip out on us, and now you're here back because you have something you want to say.
Okay, I want to get something off my chest, Joker Man. Okay? Now listen to me.
Something off your chest?
Off my chest, yes.
Show some respect, Perry.
I'm
no, you're not.
This lovely flower, this lovely Romanian flower, I sent her. It's goodwill, I sent her. And what do you do? You raped her with your eyeballs.
Oh, God.
With your eyeballs. With your eyeballs, you gave her a rim job.
Wow.
How do you know?
I heard all about it. I listened to podcasts. I could hear your eyeballs bulging from your skull.
And
licking up and down her beautiful Romanian body.
Yeah, well, she was grabbing onto, what's his face?
Brody. Okay.
Yeah.
Don't you know when to stop? Yurgi came here. He's very upset. You never know when to say you're sorry.
Yurgi,
why don't you just admit that you did something to her?
Okay, let him talk. Let him have his day in court.
Thank you. Can I say something?
Bullshit!
Okay, bullshit! Can I say something to you, my friend?
Okay.
Dude!
Bullshit!
Dude!
What?
Hey, I'm sorry, all right?
Hey, Spicoli.
Can I say I'm sorry for checking her out?
Apologize to her.
What was your name again?
Natasha.
Natasha. The eyes are gorgeous. You're a very pretty young lady. But, I'm sorry.
In Romanian.
I don't speak that language.
She can't understand English.
I don't.
This is meaningless babbling for her.
Do it with your hands.
I'm sorry, okay?
You simple words.
I'm sorry.
Vavarushka no mishka.
Go on.
I don't understand.
You must pantomime with your hands to say, I am sorry for giving you eyeball rim job last week.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You know.
She got. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Move on.
Eyeball rim job last week.
No, that was blow job you did.
And it wasn't last week. It was a few weeks ago.
A rim job. No, Perry. A rim job is when you eat someone's ass.
Yeah. It's a classic.
It was. You said that thing in the movie. Remember in the movie you did that?
I?
Yeah.
That's just one of my pearls of wisdom I like to, you know.
It's true.
Yeah.
All right. I think she's starting to understand. She's at least looking at you like she understands something.
Natasha?
Da.
I'm sorry to you. I apologize.
No, fuck now, Pavarishka.
What, you want to... He's saying he wants to fuck you?
I said...
You piece of crap. How could you come out and just say you want to fuck her?
Perry, why are you digging deeper?
It's camera.
You're supposed to apologize.
I'm not trying to say I want to fuck her now.
Listen now.
I'm not saying I want to fuck her now.
Yeah, no,
then why did you? Why did she say that?
Because that's all she knows in English. That's all you taught her to say in English.
She's got the point.
I noticed that you brought some stuff with you. What is that stuff right there?
Okay, Don, I heard you had kid. You had baby girl? I got coloring book for her. Here, take it. Kids love to color.
The cunt coloring book.
That's right.
I'm a little confused. She's under a year old.
It looks like flowers.
What's the matter? She don't like pussy? Is she a fag?
She's not a fag. She's a little baby girl.
Betty, what is this? Don's baby girl is a fag. She doesn't like pussy.
No, Donna is not a
fag. It's a baby. You don't bring a baby a fucking...
She just came squirting out of a pussy.
What are you doing?
She can relate to it.
Don't lick that. No, don't lick it. Don't lick it. What is she doing?
It's okay. She likes to lick. I trained her.
Yergi.
I trained her. When she sees pussy, she licks.
Okay, I don't know if I can use this. Well,
are there any connect the dots in there?
No. It's just a bunch of vaginas that are drawn there, and you're supposed to color it in. Well, thank you.
Connect the clot.
You brought a bucket. What's that bucket for?
Now, listen. Perry, there's one way. One way. I tried to let you apologize, but all I heard was, can I fuck you now?
No, yeah, that's getting him out of her mouth.
So, okay, listen. I'll give you one more chance. This is how you make it up to me, okay? I got business proposition. Now, let me tell
you. Wait a minute.
Business proposition?
You're going to give
money for all of us?
No. First, I don't just hand out money, okay? That's not how businessman operates, okay?
You're slick.
Yeah, I got plan, okay? Now, listen, Perry.
Oh, so this is just for Perry.
I have a new line in Romania. I'm selling Yorgi's Starcocks, okay? Now, do you understand? Do you know what Starcocks are?
No.
Okay. In Romania, there's big market for celebrity penises from molds. I take with plaster cast, I take mold of your penis, I sell them exact replica of a celebrity Hollywood penis.
Okay.
Already I have Corey Haim. I'm selling Corey Haim's cock.
Okay.
I got Scott Baio cock. That's selling very well. And then, you know what? I'm getting Corey Feldman. I'm going to make a double end, the two Coreys. I'm going to make a double ended.
Like a bookshelf?
Yeah, the two Coreys.
No, Corey Haim, that would be a good one because he passed away, correct?
Well, I got it. That was his dying wish, to have his penis sold in Eastern Europe.
So let me make sure I understand this. So what you're trying to do is.
Got the bucket of plaster, okay? And I got the spatula right here. All I got to do. Is I slather your cock, it's got to be rigid. And then I slather it with this joint compound.
I
don't think that's what he's saying.
No, you idiot. It's not for it's marijuana cigarette. It's called joint compound because because that's what they use in prison to make cock casts, okay, from the joint. So listen.
What kind of money is Perry going to make on something like this?
He's going to, first of all, he will be forgiven for eyeball raping my beautiful Natasha. Okay.
Oh, you should do it then.
Yes.
How much you want to pay me?
We do this on contingency, okay?
Wrong.
I first take mold, and every cock I sell, you get 12 cents.
Then it's never going to be done.
Romanian.
It's never going to be done. How much is 12 cents in Romanian?
Centavos.
In American?
Centnichkak.
How much American?
12 centnichkak.
How much American dollars is this going to make?
You'll be happy. Listen, you can wipe your ass with an American dollar these days, my friend.
Wipe your ass. Me.
Hold on. Hold on just a second.
I know nothing about
Romanian. Dishneskak has held its value far better than American dollar, which is no better than shit paper.
Oh, Christ. Don, if you know anything about this.
Okay, I think what he's saying right now is he's offering you 12 cents for each one he sells.
12 centavos.
What's 12
Romanian
centavos?
What
is that?
Come on, you guys. You follow the world market. That's a great deal.
I don't follow.
I don't
follow.
Really,
are you kidding me?
No. 12 cent
times. If he's able to sell these on the same scale that chickpeas are sold in Romania, he's looking at some serious money. But that's unfair that he should get all of it.
Why is it that this guy is the only one who understands
why does
business
he get
in
rich?
This room?
Why does he get rich and we don't get rich?
Because it's my dick that he wants to make a
mold
of.
Yeah, but still, but
well,
you even
yeah,
said,
but what?
It is kind of a big three thing. So do you think that maybe he could get a little less and you could share some of the profits with Mole and myself for each one sold?
Why would you guys get any profits?
Because we're the big three. If it wasn't for this podcast,
you
wouldn't get the money.
How about you get eight and we each get two?
That sounds fair to me.
Okay.
So all right, four for us, eight for you. We'll still be 12, but we'll take that other 12. I just want 2 centavos.
I just want something out of it.
So he gets 8. That's
so you're just going to make a mold right now?
Well, we're going to make him first. We have to get him hard. We have to get him.
That's hard. Her job.
Whose job?
Hey,
her job.
Keep it in your head with your eyes looking again, raping and then.
That's her job.
And licking.
Only her job.
None fuck now. Yet no. No, net fuck. Avkarashnak. Akrashnak. The Czech show. Bukarest. Nechdesh Nikolai.
She's really upset.
Hashklavash. Hashklavash. Okay. Hashklavash. Hey. Calm down. I don't. Hey.
Oh,
I
God.
Can't. Hey. Get over here. Put your head back.
Oh, my God.
Head back. Mouth open.
Whoa. My God.
What the fuck?
Down. Wash it down.
What did you just give to her?
A little something. Calm her down.
That was like 12. 20 pills.
She's drinking. What is that?
What is this? It's like hamburger helper.
Jack Daniels.
You give a little booze that extends the effect.
Wow, that's a solid buzz.
What the fuck?
Look, she's peaceful now. Just whip it out and we can start slathering this plaster on it.
All right, just so he
understands. I want a payment. I'm not getting nothing.
You.
No, look. Right. Listen to me, pal. I get nothing. You want something on my dick? If I don't get a contract in writing, one, and an upfront pay, two, for like $250,000.
Wait a minute, $250,000?
You goddamn right.
Corey Feldman didn't make these demands.
Corey Feldman is not me. He makes billions of dollars compared to what I make.
Can I say I don't need the contract for my 2 centavos? So.
And I don't either.
These guys are men of honor.
We want
Why
the
aren't
money.
You men of honor?
We see the money.
Because
potential.
I want a contract.
We don't need
I've
a contract.
I've been fucked.
Who's
hey.
Fucked you?
I've been fucked.
Who's fucked you?
I'm not going to say who's fucked me. I'm just going to say
was
I've
it Joe Paterno?
Don Barris. This is Dickie Barrett calling. Friend of yours. I know you're busy and I hate to bother you, but once again, Dickie Barrett from the Mighty Mighty Bosstones, brand new album out called The Magic of Youth, and I'm the announcer on the Jimmy Kimmel Live show. Yeah, we're friends. So anyway, I understand Perry's going into the hospital for some intricate and highly involved some HIV surgery or something. I'm not really sure. I do follow the podcast because I just love the big three. And last time he went into the hospital, you guys did a best of show or a couple of best of shows where you played old stuff from other shows. And I'd love to make a request if I could. And once again, I hate bothering you. I know you're a busy and powerful man. My first instinct would be to request about the time you guys talked about Randy Callahan, but I know that'd be difficult to find. So maybe if you could, being this the holiday season and all, and the birth of Christ our Lord is born, maybe you could have played when Perry talked about the birth of his daughter. I think that would be interesting and fun to listen to during this time of year. Anyway, Don, once again, hate bothering you. Hope Perry's doing okay in the hospital. This is your pal Dickie Barrett from the Mighty Mighty Bosstones, brand new album, Magic of Youth. just came out, and the announcer on the Jimmy Kimmel Live show. So buy that record and watch that television program. Take care, pal.
You do use condoms all the time.
I do now.
Now.
I mean, now I wasn't totally into condoms.
Everything. There's another time, not only the Randy Callahan thing, but when you had a baby, your wife, you had to squirt the fucking love juice in there.
Well, yeah, because we, look, back in the late 80s, I wasn't always using condoms. I would pull. But when her and I were having sex that one night, actually day and night,
it was a day and nighter?
Yeah, it was a day and nighter. And I knew her menstrual cycle, and I squirted in her because I knew that I was being thrown out of my mom and my aunt's place right after my Uncle Jimmy passed away. And I knew that my dad didn't even want me at his apartment, and I had nowhere to go.
You know what? Can I tell you this? I like to
so
send it.
I
well, hold on,
felt
Perry,
like
Perry, Perry, before
she
you
was the only place to go, so that's why I.
You loaded.
I got her pregnant
purposely.
Yeah.
So you deceived her.
Yes, I did.
Yes, you.
And
did.
And it was wrong thing to do, but you know I have a daughter out of that, and I love my daughter to pieces, and I'm glad, and I'm very happy that I have a child.
And you know what? What would be great too.
I would love to have my daughter come to California again.
Have her on the show? That's
she'd
great
be great
idea.
On the show.
She really would be.
Is she dating right now?
I don't know what the fuck she's doing. I know she's in the Air Force. That's all I know.
You know what would be great, though? We should cut this up so we can one day give this to her, and she can hear from her father that very special night when she was conceived.
Well, you know, it was special. I wasn't... I was in a bad situation back then, but you know, when I found out that my girlfriend at the time became my wife, you know, was pregnant, I was very happy.
Can you paint the word picture for us of what happened that night? You were just kicked out of your house?
No, I wasn't kicked out. I was
okay. So take us back there and tell us what happened, Scaremaster.
This is good. This is really good. Yeah, that's okay. A great idea.
Well, my ex-wife's name is Dolly, and Dolly and I were together, and I was in a bad state at the time, and it was kind of like, where do I go? And I knew Dolly was a legal secretary, and she was kind of hinting.
Could pay rent.
Pay rent and a lot more. And she was kind of hinting on us moving in with each other. So I kind of added a little gift for us to move in together a little quicker.
What do you mean?
Getting her pregnant.
Oh,
that
on
gift.
Purpose without her knowing.
Well, of course she knew about it. But, you know, as we were having sex together... When I had my orgasm happen, it was like, oops, I think something's very serious is going to happen.
Did you tell her that right then?
Yeah.
Did you tell her that because you felt that special little magic that they sometimes say that when it's going to happen, you feel it and you know this was it? Did you feel that?
I kind of did, yeah.
When you start thinking, boy, that money I'm going to get from her.
No, it's not that I, no, not the, it wasn't no the money about, you know, it wasn't
the
about
rent.
The rent. It wasn't about the money the and stuff.
It's easy street for Caramello.
Caravello. Why do you say Caramello? It's not with an M, you moron. It's with a V, like vicious.
Well, you call me Don a lot.
Because anyway. That's your name, all Don. Right. Durr. Anyhow, so, yeah, it was just...
You deceived her. For rule one, you deceived her.
I deceived her, and
rule
now
two,
we have...
you played it fast and loose.
Yep.
Rule three. What was rule three? Does everybody remember?
No, I don't.
I played it. I just let the flow happen.
You let the go with the flow.
Introduce this next segment of the Big Three since Don Barris, the man of Detroit, and since my boy Moe been showing mad love to the Knucker Nation, I'ma help out with the show. Even though Barry's been talking mad shit about me. Why are you starting shit, Perry? Now, there's some clip of the show when they're playing my song, Perry's Gay. When I wrote this song, I didn't know Perry would make him play the song on the podcast every 2 seconds. I mean, it's cool, it's a good song. But I don't get why Perry always being like, hey, let's play the song, let's play the song. Perry, all you do is talk about how much you want to hear my song about your special blowjob incident of 1992. Why you keep bringing up the dicks you sucked like 10 years ago? You living in the past, man. So you always talk shit about me. And I was like, all right, that's cool. But then you talk shit about Rucker's Knuckers? Motherfucker, you just pissed me off. You wanna fuck with the biggest gang on the fucking planet? You won't get fucked up now, bitch. I run this shit. Rucker's Knuckers run your fucking set. And then I did a song called Yo Perry that you were in, Perry. You talk some shit. You rap about all the dicks you sucked. All the old Randy Callahan tapes been retrieved and played in the fucking song to settle the issue once and for all. Perry, you keep talking shit. What the fuck did I ever do to you, man? You lucky your father Cookie Caramello served honorably on the fucking Navy boat or you would already be dead. I'll give you one last chance to quit running your fucking mouth about me or I'm gonna beat your fucking ass. Rucker's Knuckers for life, bitch. I don't care if your grandpa did have sex with Al Capone. What's up? This Rucker Rucker Ali. Y'all know Perry Caravello from Windy City Heat? Oh, he a big star now?
Ah, I got a movie. I don't gotta talk to none of y'all little people.
Fuck that shit, bitch. Perry Caravello is a bitch-made fag. He couldn't suck his fucking way out of a dick-shaped bag. You just a stupid motherfucker and you fatter than shit. I leave you bruised and contused, all battered and spit. Yeah, I seen you on the TV at 2 a.m. I'm balls deep in your bitch with a can of Spam. Lactose intolerant, my fucking ass. More like talent intolerant, now give me your cash. She's your bitch, she's my bitch, she's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, she's my bitch, she's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, she's my bitch, she's everybody's bitch. Perry Caravello likes sucking fucking dicks. I heard you got a job offer in Detroit City at 96.3 WNIG. You said fuck that shit, cause you in the big three. Now you getting blasted by my niggas and me. When I see you on my block, you get shot in the cock. I run your chain and your cash and your pipe and your rocks. And I don't even give a fuck if you sue me or not, cause you know you're gonna lose. I got more juice than you got. He's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. Perry Caravello likes sucking fucking dicks. What the fuck is that shit? No, that doesn't.
I like this dog, Perry. Yeah. It's a good dog. You paid it.
Perry, please be a professional.
He's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. Perry Caravello likes sucking fucking dicks. He's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. Perry Caravello likes sucking fucking dicks. He's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. Perry Caravello likes sucking fucking dicks. He's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. She's your bitch, he's my bitch, he's everybody's bitch. Perry Caravello likes sucking fucking dicks.
Rucker's Knuckers. Let them try to find me. Let them try to find me. Show them all who the king is. Oh! Let them make their threats. Rucker Rucker Ali. He's a cocksucker and he wants to suck my dick. I gotta beat his ass.
Before you started shit, shit, I was down with you, but now you fuck with Rucker's Knuckers. No, I won't cry with you. Up inside your mansion, fat bitch is down with you. Randy Callahan busted off in your hand with you. What you got in your hat full of tricks? Probably a little bit of back full of dicks. Have we won? Maybe
time to measure your inseam.
Hey, Don, it's Dominic Monaghan. I was just calling to wish you and Mo and Perry a happy Thanksgiving. I'm actually in Saint-Tropez with Greeny. We rented a yacht for the Thanksgiving period. It's fantastic over here. Beautiful weather. Greeny says hello. Anyway, listen, I had an idea for your next Best Of show. I was wondering if we could just delve into a little bit more about the relationship that Perry's ongoing with the guy that he met on the rooftop. I know Perry always goes on about Randy Callahan, the greatest blowjob I ever gave, all that kind of stuff. I'm a little sick and tired of hearing about Randy Callahan, but I'd love to hear about how his new relationship's going with the guy on the roof. Also, great news about the X-Men thing. They loved Perry's read. They thought he was really strong. They're going to be conducting some secondary meetings in person after the holiday period, but they want to make sure that everyone that turns up is a single minute man. They need to make sure that every single person can hold their breath for a minute. I think it's totally doable. I know Perry got to about 30, 35 seconds last time. I think if he just concentrates, says the phrase, professionalism is, and that is what I want, and just goes to his happy place, he'll easily hit a minute. If he can hit a minute, we'll move on to the next step. I'm really excited about this, guys. Hope you guys are all right. Happy holidays, and I'll see you soon. All right, take it easy. Bye.
What's the matter?
Me?
Yeah, you.
Mo comes upstairs. He starts in like, I'm with this guy that's laying out up on the top balcony.
Yeah? Get by the thing. See if your mic's working. Come on, sit the fuck down.
Relax,
sit the fuck down.
I got things.
Sit the fuck down.
Shut this off.
Okay, what happened now?
Mole opens up the door. I didn't even see this guy upstairs, cause there's like two levels outside, and Mole goes, "Whoa!"
Yeah.
And I didn't even see this guy sitting there. I was seated on the over at the table. And Mole's acting like, "Whoa, I gotta get out of here. I don't wanna be involved with this. Like I'm doing some gay shit. You know, this gay fucking shit better calm the fuck down or I'm gonna find a way and end it all."
What are you talking about?
Mole's bullshit.
Hey, nobody. Dudes. Hey, Mo.
Whoa, hey, Scaremaster, man. Whoa. Do I get headphones?
Yeah, right there. It's, all right. What happened upstairs? Perry's losing his mind.
There we are. I got my cans on.
All right. Whoa. All right.
Are we doing the show now?
In just a second.
Real quick.
No, shut up.
About that.
Shut up!
Fuck you!
Shut up! Shut up!
Shut up!
Sit up! Sit down! Shut up! Sit down! We're starting the show. Hit the music.
Don't even ask who I am because I'm pissed.
Well, then. You know what? That's I couldn't think of a better way to start the show, to tell you the truth. Now, what happened?
I know who it is. It's Perry.
Yeah, it is Perry. What I'm a little confused about, Perry came down here in a crazy mood. What happened upstairs?
I got to apologize, Scaremaster, man. I'm sorry, man. That is my fault.
What happened?
I should have knocked before I went out into the roof deck.
Mole opens up the door.
I know. I didn't knock. Okay, he's up there. There's another dude up there. And whatever. You know what?
What?
As everybody knows, we're in a secret location in West Hollywood, and things happen here. He's a good-looking guy. Maybe he met a guy, and the guy was starstruck.
Look,
I don't know what happened.
Look.
But there was a guy with his shirt off.
The guy that was above.
You don't have to explain anything.
Deck.
I should have knocked.
Stupid
it's
fuck.
My fault.
Retard.
Exactly. I won't do it again.
Retard.
I will knock next time.
Retard.
I apologize. What you do is your business.
Apologize for what?
For not knocking.
Knocking for what? I don't give a fuck.
Right, well.
I didn't even see the fucking guy.
Clearly, I caught you in the throes of a tryst.
Clearly, your brain is
Perry,
fucking
Perry,
twisted.
Let me try to help you with this, okay? Perry came down here, and he started with all this stuff about he doesn't want anybody calling him gay anymore.
Right.
And this is kind of pointing towards that direction, if you know what I mean. So let's.
Well.
I didn't do a fucking thing, Jagoff.
I know.
I didn't even see the fucking guy, Jagoff.
You didn't see the guy jack off?
No, I didn't see anybody.
Wait a second.
Wait a second.
Jerk off.
I don't want to know what you guys are doing.
I don't even know who this fucking guy is.
I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it.
Just drop it. Just drop it. Did you see him jacking off up there?
No. I walked in. I saw for 1 second. I saw Perry looked really excited. Like, oh, my God, what are you doing here? And the guy stood up in his chair, and he didn't have any shirt on. And, you know, it was just awkward, and I felt terrible. And, Perry, I apologize. It won't happen again.
Yeah, right.
Okay, beautiful. Then we can start the show then.
Hello, Big Three. Shalom. This is Sal Steinbergowitz Greenbaum. I'm visiting with my friends, the Spiegelmans, here in Miami. The weather is delicious. I'm taking a break to call you. And, well, let's see. It's difficult for me to list my favorite moment on the podcast this year. And what's easier is listing my least favorite moment, which, of course, was the time Perry knocked a microphone into my leg, causing severe arthritis and gingivitis of the tibia, which of course led to gangrene, and I unfortunately had to consider amputation, but thank heavens the great Dr. Julius Irving was able to initiate a procedure preventing that catastrophic result. And of course, no apologies from the man responsible for this, Perry Caramello, and I could have sued for many, many thousands of dollars and dozens of skateboards, but I chose not to. Not one apology, not one visit, not one care in the world. I pray for you, Perry. I pray for your wretched soul right now.
Baruch atah Adonai Alanahu Melech Halom Asher Verestik Alalam Verestik Labestik Ol Meshapot Avesisad Avra Chachimim Blemuna Vendyat Randikalahen.
In other words, good luck to you, you sad, despicable, ungrateful vermin. Shalom.
Can I get a big three?
Big three! Well, and you speak about your charities. One of them that you got...
Oh, so weed!
Yeah, you were saying that kind of. High-fived you. The Chilean mine collapse really affected you in a strong way.
It did, yeah. And later on in the show, we're going to be doing something special.
What'd you do, Perry?
God damn it. Was
first day on the show, and you break the fucking...
Get in here!
Get in here! God damn it!
All
right. Saul.
Oof.
Wait, Saul's leg.
What happened?
No, wasn't even hooked up right for me!
Wait a minute. Is that your leg?
Yeah, it's below the knee.
Saul's leg. Are you okay?
That's very sore. I mean, you guys saw what happened, right?
I saw. Perry hit the mic. It hit you.
And then it fell on my...
It seemed to me he threw it at you.
Yeah.
Are you okay, Saul?
I think I'm okay. I don't know. I mean, this is... I've had a pre-existing injury here, but, I mean, this might be something new.
Yeah, it looked pretty rough.
It wasn't even connected right.
If you don't knock the base, it won't come off.
Though. Hey, Donnie, has that ever happened before on any other show here?
First time in the history of the network here.
Okay.
Fine.
Okay, and who fucked it up? Just introduce yourself.
Perry
Hold
Caramel.
Hold on. Saul, do you want to prop your leg or anything?
I think maybe if I keep it elevated.
Should we get
or
ice
something?
Or
yeah.
You want to drain it?
Well, let me just try to lift it there for a second.
There you go. Put it right up there.
Because that was bad.
Set up.
That was bad.
Okay.
He set you up?
I was set up.
Who hit it?
I didn't hit it. The damn thing came off the table.
Okay. All right, introduce yourself.
Perry Caravello, better known as the Scare Master, Scary Perry.
And where do you live?
In a house.
What's
an apartment. What do you mean, what's my address? What's your address? What's his address? Why do I have to give out my address? I'm not giving out my address, and you better keep your fucking mouth shut!
What are you so mad for? We're not even 5 minutes into the show. You've already injured Saul Steinbergowitz Greenbaum. You've done nothing but scream. You are the most unprofessional guy I've ever worked with. Mole, am I wrong on this?
I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Me.
Okay, is that all you want to say about yourself?
I'm the Comedy Central star of the cult classic film Windy City Heat, and I have a skateboard company called Scary Perry Skateboards.
Don't promote that. We can't promote that on this.
Oh.
Okay. Now, the reason we brought...
I love Scary Perry Skateboards.
Here's what we're going to do. Saul, the reason we brought you in today... Are you okay?
It's just that it's throbbing now, but, I mean, we're going to... Let's push through this.
You'll be okay. All right, Saul.
Hi, Big Three Podcast. This is Jimmy Kimmel, longtime listener, first-time caller. On the Best Of Show, I would like to hear the time I called in to give you advice on how to do a podcast. And I was wondering if now, 14 months later, you took any of my advice. And also, I'm wondering, because I'm hearing a lot of different stories about Perry being gay, Perry not being gay. I honestly don't know what to think. Thanks, Big Three Podcast.
Hey, is this another phone call?
Hi.
Hello.
Hello, is this the Big Three?
It's late night talk show host. It's Jimmy Kimmel.
Jimmy Kimmel?
Well, thank you. Hi, guys. How you guys doing?
Excellent. Where are you calling from?
Really good.
I'm calling from the car.
The car? Are you in Chile, too?
I really got a sense of humor there. Never mind. Little earlier, Perry hurt Saul Steinbergowitz pretty bad.
Stop. How's your leg hurt him?
Saul, how are you doing?
Still throbbing. There's a little pain, but...
Perry hit Saul Steinbergowitz Greenbaum with the microphone stand and broke
not
his knee.
Not on purpose.
Well,
oh, that is...
not
wow.
on purpose.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow, maybe we can get that money back.
Yeah, they can look
at what money?
Look
at the money? What money?
Remember when you sued us, Perry?
That was a long time ago because I didn't get my residual check. Where's my residual check, huh? That's why I sued. Okay?
I don't know, but if you do get one, I see it going right to Saul Steinbergowitz.
That's right.
I guess so, huh?
That's right.
I guess so.
America.
But you know what? We're not allowed to talk about any lawsuits or when Perry had sex with that guy Sandy Gallagher.
Yeah.
So don't
bring any of that.
Hold on a second. Probably it'd be best if you let me know what. We're not supposed to talk
okay,
about.
Go ahead. Let's
well,
let
me,
I'll tell you.
I'll, I can get through this pain. Okay. Don, the thing you can't talk about with Don is how he has sex with all the Hollywood starlets. He gets embarrassed and he doesn't want that
yeah,
brought
what,
up.
Yeah, what starlets?
Shut your
well,
fucking
we're not
mouth.
Gonna bring that
what starlets?
Don, let me tell you. Don, can I say something?
Anything you'd like.
I really think if you're going to do this podcast, you've got to lay it all out there. And I just, you know, it seems like people want to hear about that. And you should be open to speaking about it. I know you have sex with a lot of women, a lot of famous women. Mm. And, you know, listen, it's part of the deal.
All right, you've done some things in radio. Oh, all right. Check that one off. I will talk
all
about
right, good.
Some of the
I just think it's important to be open, that's all.
All right.
Okay, what else, Saul?
Okay, Mole asked that we don't discuss what happened to him when he worked on Shark Week.
It was bad.
Okay, well...
I got
you know what, Mo?
Yeah.
I'm gonna throw the same thing out of here.
Don't throw anything at me.
He's not gonna
throw. Shark, not literally. I mean, Shark Week is you know, that's in the public domain, and that's something that if people want to hear about what happened during Shark Week, I really think that if you're gonna commit yourself to this podcast, that you have to talk about that kind of thing.
God, he's good.
He really is. All he worked right. on K-Rock.
He's been on K-Rock. He was on Saul Steinbergowitz. Or wait, no.
Right,
no.
Thank
wrong
you,
show.
Thank you.
Win Ben Stein's Money, that's right.
Right.
Yeah. Win Ben Stein's Money and what's that other show? Oh, yeah, The Man Show.
He has another
Perry knows that
The Whoa Man Show.
Will you listen to him talk? Quit being so...
Perry knows that you have to be completely open if you're going to be on the radio, on a podcast. If you're going to share with your listeners, you have to share everything.
But Jimmy...
Okay, what else?
His
okay,
list
well
is
that,
big.
All right, well, that just leaves Perry. It's maybe a tougher nut to crack. Perry says no talk about his relationship with Sandy Gallagher. And
I never had a relationship with Sandy Gallagher. I don't even know who that
okay,
is.
Okay, I don't know. Who is Sandy Gallagher? I know Randy Callahan.
That's it. That's it.
That's
name. It.
That's the guy that
we
blew.
We couldn't think of the name. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, just like Perry was saying before, I mean, you know, well, Perry, you say it best. I mean, tell these guys what you got to do if you want to host a podcast.
I'm not talking about what you just mentioned.
Right, but if everyone else wants to talk about it while you're sitting there, I mean, I think you have to go along with that.
I'm willing to talk
what's
about
there, the... What's there to talk about?
Okay, you're doing a commercial for Alvarado Hospital.
Yeah.
Correct.
Oh, yeah. Congratulations.
No, this is before.
That
this
was back in 92.
Yeah.
And you wanted to do a movie with Christina Applegate.
No, he was going to be an extra in it. He
and
could
I
get the...
did become an extra in that film.
And
that...
then you blew Randy Callahan.
I did not blow Randy Callahan. Yeah.
He didn't blow Randy Callahan.
No, thank you, dude.
He blew
Jimmy.
You.
Okay.
I had to give him the knuckle shuffle on his piss pump.
What? What is that exactly? You jerked him off.
Yes.
The knuckle shuffle on his fist pump.
On his piss pump.
Piss pump.
That's really clever. All right.
And how did it go? I mean, did it work? You wound up getting the job, right?
Yes, I did the job, and I got the... I worked on Tehachapi.
So it worked out for you.
So it was like a little light gay prostitution.
Okay, period. Next subject,
please. All right, see, now, guys, look, there's Terry right there.
Right.
Opening up and sharing things.
Okay, but that's not all he wanted to not talk about. All right, what else did he not want to talk about?
And then there's this other issue that's off limits.
The family
Perry
issue?
Perry does not want to discuss how he's suing his family.
I am interested in that. What is going on with that? I don't know anything about it.
There's no lawsuit against my aunt. You know, when the courts say that you're not allowed to talk about it out of court, that means you can't talk about it.
I'm confused because you just gave these guys a lecture about opening up about Don's sexual dalliances and mold experiences at Shark Week.
That's true.
And now it just seems a little weird, that's all.
Jimmy, if I may defend Perry for a second, when it comes to legalities and such, when there's a pending issue, such as like the assault on my knee, Perry, you didn't see it earlier, but if you watch the podcast, I'm not allowed to talk about that. Just like Perry's not allowed to talk about this whole suing family issue.
Well, wait a minute, Saul. You did talk about that.
Oh, I did?
You were talking
whatever.
About that.
Oh, okay.
Well, you could open up then, too, if Saul's willing
to
talk about it.
No, I can't. It's called court. And the judge, if the judge sees this garbage and says this case has got to get dismissed because it was on a public matter, oh, boy. Oh, boy.
No.
I don't even want to go that route.
I don't know.
I don't even want to go that route because you know what'll happen.
Jimmy, I'm not an attorney, but
the judge's name. I'm sure I know him.
What?
What's the judge's name? I could talk to him.
The judge's name.
I'm not bringing up the name of the judge.
Why?
It's going to give me a heart attack if it's not done right, and this is being brought out.
Can I say something? If this gives you a heart attack, you're going to make a fortune. I mean, this really could be bad.
Oh, yeah, well, let him die, right?
Good point.
He's good.
Good point.
See, I can't say the judge's name. I'm just going to
Is it Judge Sandy Gallagher?
I don't know Judge Sandy Gallagher.
Judge Judy?
No, it's not Judge Judy. That right there, it's not Judge Judy.
Joe Brown?
I'm not saying who the judge is.
Who's the judge?
I'm not mentioning the judge's name.
Extreme Akeem?
Saul, you know a lot
Next
of judges.
Subject, please.
I think maybe we should still keep guessing.
Next subject,
you guess?
Please.
We could probably pull the records on this and figure out who the judge is.
I know some people.
Judge Reinhold?
I'm going to take care of my knee after a couple weeks of rehab, and then I'm going to look into this matter.
Judge Dredd? That leg is looking rough, Saul.
I know. Well, thank you, Perry, for letting me keep it up.
I'm sorry, Saul.
It's another potential lawsuit right there.
You know you have a price tag on the bottom of your shoe?
I do. Yeah, I'm returning these after the show.
Oh.
It feels like the interview has lost some direction.
A little bit.
Well, that's something you guys should really figure out. Like, I mean, maybe next time, Perry, you should come in with a list of questions, and you guys should do the same thing.
Oh, he is.
So you want me to come up with questions then?
Well, you should each come up with questions and bring them in and...
Okay.
You know, and now we have things to ask your guests about.
So let's give a big warm welcome and a goodbye to late night talk show host Jimmy Kimmel, everybody.
Welcome,
Jimmy.
Welcome and goodbye.
Thank you for being on our very first
nice,
podcast.
Nice talking to you, buddy.
I was talking, Perry. Thanks for being on the podcast.
It is an honor and a pleasure. Thank you, Big Three.
All right. And there he is, Jimmy Kimmel,
our producer of Windy City Heat.
Shalom.
Don Barris, Andy Dick, your old pal, Mr. Dick to you. How you doing, buddy? Listen, I hear you're going to be doing a best-of show, and I want to throw in my 2 cents, which, by the way, in this economy is worth about 7 cents, because I don't know about everybody else, but I'm doing great. Thank you, Obama. But anyhow, before I tell you the clip I want to hear, I would like to promote a new movie I'm in. It's called Division 3, Football's Finest. It is a football comedy. If you like football, watch the movie. If you like to laugh, watch the movie. If you like football and you like to laugh, if you don't watch the movie, you're a fucking retard. I play a football coach, and it's fun. It's good stuff, and it's on video on demand. And then in January, you can buy it on DVD. But anyways, the clip I want to hear from your podcast is, remember that time I went to Perry's apartment to do the...
the podcast, and I brought my assistant, and who at the time he was dying of AIDS. Sad to say, he is dead. He died of AIDS. Remember, I got, the blood was everywhere because I was shaving his balls. This and that. Harry should get tested because I remember there was blood all over his sink, and I know he probably brushes his teeth and washes his face in that sink. And then your friend, your buddy that does the podcast with you, was trying to disinfect me with lighter fluid. What kind of moronic show do you run over there? Fuck! That's why I haven't been back. But I would like to hear the clip when I was there, because there has been some time and distance in between when I was there and now, and yeah, I might find it amusing. At the time, I was quite upset. At this point, I think it would be a good time to roll the clip. God bless you, Don Barris, and I'll see you soon. I love you.
What happened, Andy? Are you still in the bathroom?
Let me see what's going on in there.
I hope the guy is not doing anything.
Andy, are you in there?
He needed help.
Positive. Is everything okay?
Yeah, no, don't rush us. I'm kind of doing. He wanted me to shave positive. Him a little.
What? Wait a minute. What?
In your bathroom.
What are you shaving?
Shit. Oh fuck! Shit! God!
Don't get him out! You scare him out of it.
Bitch.
What's going on in there? Open up.
Please don't come in right now.
Watch so you've been with the fanny pack at home, huh?
That's gone.
Yeah, you would think
at
one point
you would take it off,
but I don't trust anybody. That's why I'm...
You think we're going to just quickly run over and take your fanny pack?
Can you please? Paper towels.
You have any paper towel?
What happened?
You got cut shaving.
Okay, here you go.
He started shaving his balls. That was not me. He was shaving his balls.
Why is your blood on your mouth?
Because I was helping him wipe it all. I don't, you know what? Right now,
is there blood on the floor?
Situation. No, but there is a little bit. Yeah. He was shaving his fucking nuts. I can't help it.
Why were you shaving his nuts?
He asked me to help him. I didn't want to. I just, you know what?
Is the door?
What the fuck is going on in there?
We're cleaning up. I'm trying to clean up. I'm so sorry.
Dan, let Perry deal with that.
All right, get
Excuse me. What the fuck are you guys doing in here?
He'll deal with that.
What the fuck are you guys doing
cleaning
in here?
Up. I'm so sorry.
What the fuck are you guys doing
in
here?
What's going on? I'm sorry. I apologize. We're going to do a quick ball shaving.
All right.
I was shaving my face.
Yeah.
What's going on?
There's blood in the fucking sink.
Get out now?
Yeah, get out.
I'm out of here.
Well, take your fucking clothes, dude, and you're driving me.
Okay.
You better wait. I don't want to touch the pubes. That is just...
All right, those are pubes. Do you have...
Use the toilet paper or something and wipe it off.
Let me just see something here.
I was going to take a quick shower.
A quick shower in my fucking place?
I was on to shave.
Get the fuck out of here.
Nuts.
All right. What happened? All right.
I'm so sorry.
Well, why don't you...
I'll clean it up.
Clean it up,
here, let me get this.
Clean it up, please.
He's HIV positive.
He's fucking, he's got AIDS.
All right, get the blood out of here.
Clean it up, please.
All right, clean this up, and when you're done, come out here and we'll close the show. Here's some paper towel. Let's sit down. Let's clean
it. It's in my mouth. I just realized.
Clean it up, please.
I don't want to touch the blood and the puke.
Oh, my fucking God.
I'll clean it up.
Oh, my fucking God.
Make sure it's not
right, Perry, let's do this. Let's do your 60 seconds right now. All right.
60 seconds.
All right. 60 seconds where you get to promote anything you want. All right. Here we are. You got 60 seconds. Christ. And
I don't have
go!
Come back in here and
Scary Perry Skateboards. ScaryPerryProductions.com. Get these guys out of my house.
Okay. We're just about done. Just go through this and promote the skateboard.
I cannot help.
All right. What's the matter? Hey, I think it's best that you get out.
Yo, can you get the clothes?
Get
the clothes, please. Get
the clothes.
Get the fucking towel away. Just put it in the bag. No, give it. All right, Perry, do your 60 seconds with Perry. Go. Talk about your skateboard.
60 seconds. ScaryPerryProductions.com is the website not, company.
I have cold
okay,
there.
All right, all right.
That, okay.
Get all.
All right, he's in the middle of his 60 seconds.
You, I don't want
to. Hold on, hold on.
AIDS is seeping into my body.
Hold on, hold on. Did Andy, have him go outside. Let me just.
Hurry up, put your shirt on. I got some alcohol,
I got some Paisano wine.
All right, please. All right, wait outside.
Give him a hug, Gary.
Get the fuck out of my house.
Come on.
Get out of my house!
Don't hug him! Don't hug him! Get him out! Harry! 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 Get out! Get out! Just get out! Just hey!
No bad blood!
No bad blood!
Deck the halls with boughs of ooh. Hey everybody in podcast land, it's terrifying. Wow, what a year it's been. God, looking back, it's been such a blur. I'm starting to get emotional. I mean, just looking back, one minute I'm just a positive, pretty hardworking kid from Winthrop, Massachusetts, with nothing more than a thick accent, zero acting experience, and a freaking dream. And now look at me. It's a lot of prayer, positivity, and Marky Mark Wahlberg's excellent Lose Your Accent and Be a Wicked Good Actor Now series of instructional acting DVDs. Well, now I'm a super successful actor in Hollywood. In 1 year, I mean, I've already starred in 13 national television and radio commercials. My mailbox is filled every single day with residual checks from I don't even know what. I own a completely unique, one-of-a-kind skateboard company, and sales are through the roof through purely grassroots marketing, all word of mouth and email stuff. I moved my manufacturing to China, so my overhead's like nothing. You can make skateboards for a zip over there, and it's just pure, pure profit. You wouldn't believe what people are willing to pay for one of my boards. What can I say? God is great. Also, I'm not officially allowed to talk about it yet, but some big things might be afoot with Beantown Heat. But best of all, I'm still a virgin. I've remained pure to my God and to my beliefs, and I've survived yet another year on Earth without succumbing to temptation. I'm nearly 35 and still proudly a virgin. Hey, if I could make a request, though, I would love it if you guys would play my ASM plumbing and porn commercial. It's some of my most intense and emotional acting work to date. I'm very, very proud of it. And also, every time it's played, I get a huge, fat, big, tasty residual check. Big Frishy!
It's time for the ASM Plumbing and Porn segment. And I believe that today we actually have a video here from the new Terrifying Tim piece. Let me turn on the TV.
He's cleaning up on this.
This could have been you, Perry.
Hi, I'm Terrifying Tim for ASM Plumbing and Porn. You want hot man-on-man films and top-notch plumbing and piping? Call ASM! Now, I may not be nearly as gay as their last spokesman, but I do know quality cornhole when I see it. Let's unclog some pipes! ASM Plumbing and Porn. Tell them Terrifying Tim sent you.
How the fuck did they splice it to where they got some cock in my hands or in somebody's hands to where it makes it look like it's me?
What are you talking about? It's a picture of you.
But I'm not grabbing onto some dick.
Look!
That's not me
hanging
onto a
that's
dick.
That's you.
You could have been the spokesman for it. There's a job
not
you blew.
I'm not interested in being a faggot.
Whoa. Pretty freaking heavy right there, Perry.
Right.
Sounds negative the way you
say
it.
Well, because it's exactly the way I think. I'm not gay, I'm not a homosexual, I'm not a faggot.
What? Why are you so angry? I'll bet you that's a sugar rush that you're going through right now.
Hello, Big Three. Johnny Adams calling. Congratulations on all your wonderful accomplishments thus far. You know, when asked what some of my favorite moments from the podcast were, I must confess I drew a blank. Because I love them all. Then I thought, I rather enjoy it when the Big Three take off their comedy caps and dive headlong into the deep issues of the day, like the time Perry weighed in on the 10-year anniversary of the 9/11 tragedy. Such insight and sensitivity. Though, I do also like to hear him talk about his grandfather and Al Capone's relationship. But I think I'll go with that, the 9/11 anniversary talk. And please, can you dedicate it to Big Lester, the muscular Negro orderly at my nudist rehabilitation facility, Naked Truth? Toodles all!
We're taping the show a little bit early, but on Sunday is the 10th anniversary of a tragedy like no other tragedy in my lifetime. And
You're talking about the 9/11 tragedy?
Nothing gets by
you.
You're absolutely right, both of you guys.
Yeah,
knew it.
We ought to go on some kind of quiz show with the three minds here. We could win everything.
Like if you go, for 500, what is the tragedy that's the biggest tragedy that Dan knew in his life? Scaremaster.
The 9/11 podcast? The 9/11 tragedy in New York.
What happened there exactly?
Well, there was the three airplanes that hit the World Trade Center.
And that was it?
And it killed over 3,000 people. Turned the lives of millions around.
Yes, it did.
Do you guys remember where you were when you heard about the 9/11?
My mom called me up and told me to turn on Channel 11.
Why 11?
Well,
because the 9/11?
Either 11 or 7. She was.
Which one was it?
It was either 7 or 11.
I know, but which one was it?
I don't remember.
Well, try to think.
Because I'm thinking 7 was her favorite channel.
So 7 or 11 on 9/11, and what's your favorite Slurpee at 7-Eleven?
Good point.
My favorite Slurpee? Strawberry.
Okay. Dan, where were you?
I got a phone call, and it was Saul Steinbergowitz Greenbaum, and he asked me if I saw what was happening. And I saw on the TV, I had ESPN on. And they had coverage on, so I knew this was serious. And, you know, after that, we went through 9 years of trying to get to the people that did it. And finally, our good friend, Tim Perpetic, gave the money that finally got me.
Oh, I think that's a crock of crap.
Where were you, Mole?
You know what the funny thing is? I don't really remember, but I remember hearing about it. But you know what I remember is that that was the beginning of the war on terror and the war on people trying to bring weed onto a plane.
Yeah, that's true.
Who really pays? And you know what else it started with? That cop who kept singing the national anthem after that. That was the worst. That opera cop?
I don't think he was that bad.
Yeah. Narc.
Why do you call him a narc, Mo?
Total cop.
Yeah.
Well, he acted like he was a cool singer.
Who are you talking about?
Cop. You know, like he's like, hey, I'm a cool singer. Hang out and we'll all get high after the big national anthem. But he was a cop.
Oh.
Well, that was a great best of show, Dan.
I wanted to get the fuck out of here.
Perry, we're almost done. Then you can get the fuck out of here, okay? Okay, well, anyway. Mole, what do you think? How should we end this podcast?
One of my favorite, and I think everybody's favorite musical selections from the podcast is when we all get together and we get to hear the Scaremaster rip out some AC/DC.
Oh, that's perfect, Mole. I could think of no better way to end this than with Perry singing. Perry, what AC/DC song are you going to end with?
You name it. I can't sing it because my voice is
You know what we should do? Have him sing Back in Black.
Oh, that's what everyone wants to hear.
No.
Everybody come wants on, to hear it. Let's hear you. Let's hear you. Let's see if you can dig in your soul.
My voice is gone.
All right.
My voice is gone.
Your voice is gone? What do you
I want to go home.
All right, okay. But Perry, we're in the middle of something.
I don't give a shit.
You don't give a shit.
I'm fucking sick.
You don't give a shit.
I want to fucking die. Let me go home and die.
Okay, well, you got to sing this song, if you
I'm
would.
Not singing
Hit the music. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Loose from a noose. That's when me and my get my
Stop, stop, yeah, stop, stop, stop.
Great best of show.
All right, anyway, let's take it out with Perry singing Back in Black. Pop.
I want to get the fuck out of here. I want to get out of here.
All right, just sing it again. Here we go.
You know how to put somebody through hell. Yeah. You really do. And you love it. You know I'm ill. You know I don't have a fucking voice with shit. You know my hands all fucked up.
You missed your cue. Stop the music. Do you do anything but complain?
Right now, yeah, I do nothing but complain.
Mary Jane, do you have any songs that you could sing to kind of take us out?
Sing some low and slow.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
To who?
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. To you.
See you next time. Hopefully Perry's not dead. Put it there, guys. Big three!